Good morning everybody. I will talk to you about a young midwife's journey. It is based on my experience when I work in the community. Yes, slide please. Indonesia is the world's largest archipelago with over 17,000 islands. It is the fourth most populous country in the world, with around 240 million people who are mostly Muslim. It is a democratic country with a decentralized system of governance, where basic services, including health, are delivered by local government. I work as a midwife in Sindang Dataran, a rural agricultural community in Bengkulu province, southwestern of Sumatra. You can see the red sign. There are 1,728 people in my village, which is 68 kilometers away from the city. I work in the primary health center in Indonesia called Puskesmas. I began serving my government and community after I complete my midwifery education in 2007. I'm one of over 90,000 nurses and midwives in the Indonesian workforce today who are helping reduce our country high maternal mortality ratio and address other sexual and reproductive health problems such as early marriage, childbirth and HIV. I'm so grateful to the organizer of the 7APJRHR for giving me opportunity to share my experience with these two eminent health system global experts. But honestly, the method of facing this august body of SRHR policymakers, program implementers, civil society and development partners from various Asia-Pacific countries and from other world regions is really scary me. But I was attracted to that because I am a young frontline health worker. My experience could provide useful contribution in this conference. I'm honored that I can share my own little way some useful lesson for the future of SRHR in countries such as mine. I was 17 years old when I entered the Poltekkes Midwifery School in Jambi Province, Sumatra. My school was on, next slide please. Yeah. My school is one of the four pilot schools in my country that participated in midwifery curricular reform project by Yayasan Pendidikan Kesehatan Perempuan or Women's Health Education Foundation in partnership with Ikatan Bidan Indonesia or Indonesian Midwifery Association, Indonesian Women NGOs, and Filipino expert, with support from the Ford Foundation. Next slide. I was one of 90 young women who were selected from rural area with no midwives or with inadequate number of midwives from different islands of Indonesia to become the first batch of project schooler. This program has so far provided over 500 schoolers in it, started in 2004. Among the major requirements were a high school diploma and kinship with either a dukun, or traditional healer or a community health provider. The innovative midwifery curriculum did not only provide us with birthing and other clinical skills, it also taught us about human rights, gender, woman empowerment, international agreement like ICPD Program of Action, national laws and policies, community development, poverty and other social determinants, community health, culture and religion, and scientific through social data research. I also learned how to speak English because we had an American volunteer who wanted to learn Bahasa Indonesia. So our ex-deal was that he would teach us the English language. We had gender sensitivity training when we start our program, and this provided us with gender lens throughout our midwifery course and beyond. Gender relation was mainstream in several subjects. We were taught and encouraged to advocate for gender equality and equity. Next slide. After obtaining the midwifery degree, the other young midwives and I joined additional YPKP seminar on sexuality and adolescent reproductive health and male involvement in SRH and FP that were conducted by local and foreign experts. We were also taught emergency, maternal and neonatal care and visual training to detect signs of cervical cancer using acetic acid. This additional training activities enhance our skills in communicating with adolescents and in understanding and talking about sexuality. After the next slide. After the pre-service training, my schoolmates and I agreed to keep in touch with each other and continually inform YPKP about our life experience when we would return to our respective communities. Luckily, we belong to a generation that can quickly communicate through mobile phone and through the internet, especially on Facebook. Thus, we constantly share our experience and other life events. We are able to quickly seek the advice of our mentors, YPKP, other classmates, and scholars from other regions for similar issues. Yeah, next slide. Many of you have worked in rural area know that there are many challenges in this social setting. I was lucky that I was absorbed by the public health system to work as a midwife in rural community. The location where I work is very far from the town, and the roads can get flooded and very muddy during the rainy season, which starts in November until April. Initially, I had problems about acceptance by my community because I was young and unmarried. But because I'm the only midwife in my community who must implement all the government health program for the village, so the community had to deal with me. The health station where I am working provide basic primary care service, but the people expected that I also help them in all their health problems like a medical doctor. My community had low health knowledge, and I encounter many cultural beliefs and practices are not good for health. The community is poor and must cannot pay some health services. which are not provided for the free by the health facility. So they pay in a kind like rice, vegetable, fruits, pets, and other. Yeah. Sometimes they could pay anything because of poverty. So I link them to the local government for the local health insurance. The name in Indonesia is Jamkesda. And other social protection programs of government like Jampersal. Young people began, sorry, it is the picture in my activity in the community. Yeah, next slide. It is talking to the youth about sexuality and reproductive health. Yeah, next slide. Next slide, please. Yeah, I suppose I must have performed well in my job because in 2007, the Jang Lebong Regency and Bengkulu Province had given me appreciation award for my work in community health as a midwife and nurse for maternal and child health. On the same year, the Ministry of Health of Indonesia has given me an appreciation award as young national professional nurse and midwife. Yeah, next slide please. There are lessons have I learned from my training at community health work. A comprehensive midwifery curriculum with the human rights and gender equality framework like the one developed by YPKP and Indonesian Midwifery Association to other school and province is very useful in the field and should be the direction in training midwives beyond 2015. A midwife, no matter how old she is, becomes a community leader, therefore it's necessary for her to develop leadership skill to engage the community not only for health and in other aspects of community and family life, sexuality education, environmental conservation and protection, even livelihood among others. To get accepted by the community, a midwife must work with the people continually, but she must be sensitive and responsive to their health and other needs. Being a young midwife, I find that I can be an effective peer educator to the youth and because they can easily relate it to me. The training about adolescent reproductive health and sexuality made it easier for me to communicate and counsel the young regarding SRHR issues confronting them. However, an innovative pre-service training is not enough. This should be complemented by support from local government and the formal health system to absorb us after we complete our innovative training. I believe that government and Indonesian Midwifery Association, are doing their best to provide continuing education to update senior midwives about gender relations, human rights, and other SRHR matters. This effort should be, yeah?
2 minutes.
Yeah, this effort should be continually done to reduce the generation gap between the young and older midwives. Before I end, I would like to thank medical doctor, midwife, NGO who have tirelessly worked together to develop and implement YPKP innovative project. that has integrated the ICPDPOA in the midwifery curriculum to fulfill their mission of training midwives with human rights and gender equality. Some of them have passed on, like past POGI president, Professor Gulardi and Bidan Harney. They are the modern day heroes of the ICPDPOA. Terima kasih banyak and have a productive discussion during the parallel session.